Chapter 459, Deference. Strange. How did she know that you were cultivating the blood spirit heart from so far away? A few minutes after Zhu Moyan had left, Song Tina came out from inside a clump of tree leaves. A five-colored light ray was rippling magically around her body. Qin Lai was inside a light ray as well. When he detected Zhu Moyan's approach, he immediately withdrew the blank tombstone and told Song Tina to use the spirit artifact and hide their presence. The duo then hid themselves inside it. The duo had stuck close to each other and placed themselves inside a small light barrier. Through the tree leaves, they watched Zhu Moyan searching around with a deeply suspicious look before ultimately leaving with great reluctance. Since Zhu Moyan had left the place already, Song Tina slowly withdrew the colorful light barrier. While sniffing the fragrance from Song Tina and pressing close to her shapely and attractive body, Qin Lai couldn't help but feel a little hot on the inside as he began to think of certain things. In silence, he continued to stick close to Song Tina while his eyes shone with a fiery and passionate light. Why are you avoiding her? You should tell her the relationship between you and Zhu Li. You should have befriended her as soon as possible. This will be beneficial to our future activities in the graveyard of the gods. Song Tina muttered in a small voice. Qin Lai still didn't say anything. Feeling strange on the inside, Song Tina turned around to glance at him before she froze suddenly. An intoxicating blush quietly appeared on her beautiful face. She had noticed the passion in Qin Lai's eyes in first glance, and knew what Qin Lai was thinking in his mind right now. This scoundrel. Song Tina scolded on the inside, but was smart enough to keep silent at this opportune moment. When they were hiding inside a bush, Song Tina was at the front while Qin Lai was at the back. They were leaning close to each other and could feel each other's body temperature clearly and even hear the faint but rapid heartbeats. The atmosphere was incredibly charming and gentle right now. A dozen or so seconds later, Qin Lai subconsciously hugged Song Tina's sexy body into his arms. Amidst soft cries, Song Tina's half-lidded eyes watched on as Qin Lai's face swiftly grew larger in her vision. In the next moment, Qin Lai suddenly leaned close and kissed her. Amen. She did not put up any resistance at all. Song Tina closed her eyes obediently and returned his kiss passionately. Sha-sha. The sounds of leaves and their own bodies rustling against each other resounded from within the tree leaves. Bang. Qin Lai, finding himself unable to move as he wanted inside the tree leaves, suddenly dropped down from the tree while holding Song Tina. While hugging each other, the duo dropped beneath the tree with Song Tina's back pressed against the tree. A pair of big hands explored her shapely body and the seductive valleys and peaks without restraint. Song Tina's eyes were lost and distant as she panted in a soft tone. The impressive blush that appeared on her neck was literally irresistible. She had a tall figure and her bosom was round and full. The bounciness of her breasts were equally amazing, and Qin Lai loved it so much that he couldn't wait to make all kinds of shapes with them. Another one of Qin Lai's hands roamed down her back and attacked her secret spot wantonly, invading the private area that belonged to him and him alone. Song Tina did not even put on a token resistance. She was completely lost in both heart and body. She had already acknowledged Qin Lai fully inside her heart. When she was infected with the voodoo toxin, losing both her life and soul energy little by little while being hunted by black voodoo cults martial practitioners relentlessly. She had already made up her mind to not hesitate and hide her feelings if she could run into Qin Lai once more. Just when she thought she was about to die a horrible death and never see Qin Lai again, the gods actually seemed to heed her prayer and presented Qin Lai before her. Qin Lai had successfully saved her from the claws of the black voodoo cult's followers. After that, for a period of time Qin Lai attempted all kinds of methods in order to cure the voodoo poison. When he discovered that nothing was working, he then carried her on his back and set out with the goal of finding Yi Hao and killing the mother insect so he could save her from the poison. Even she did not hold any hope at all and thought that Qin Lai would fail in his attempt. She did not think that she would be able to survive. But Qin Lai ultimately succeeded in acquiring the voodoo insect's blood. As a result, she was pulled back from the edges of death through the use of one drop of voodoo insect blood. Everything Qin Lai did for her sake, she saw. From Du Xiang Yang and Chu Li, she even learned that Qin Lai had charged regardless of all perils into an area covered with voodoo toxin and fought the eight-winged centipede queen bravely. Everything Qin Lai had filled her heart up with his figure until it was full. She had completely acknowledged Qin Lai in both body and mind. Therefore, she could not raise even a bit of resistance towards Qin Lai's needs at all. Her clothes were pulled open, revealing a huge area of her white breasts. Her white, jade-like skin was glowing with such an attractive luster that it was as if a person's eyeballs would become sucked to it. Qin Lai had completely fallen for her charm. Tap tap, tap tap. A rapid series of footsteps swiftly returned from afar. The duo who was about to lose control swiftly broke out of their trance as Song Tina hurriedly covered them both with a light shield once more. The duo's figure swiftly became invisible. Zhu Moyan's beautiful figure had appeared into the opening once more. Her suspicious eyes observed her surroundings for a moment before she ultimately left again in dejection. A long time later, the light shield beneath the tree was released as the duo's figure showed up once more. With half a breast exposed and a face filled with embarrassment and a playful pout, she said, "Thank goodness I reacted in time, or. The fiery passion in Qin Lai's eyes too faded bit by bit as he grinned, "Or what? Or we would have been caught red-handed." Song Tina smiled beautifully and lightly pushed him away, "You scoundrel. It hasn't been that long since the voodoo toxin on me was cured, but you're already thinking about bad things. Thank goodness Zhu Moyan came back, or I would have been preyed on by you already. You pervert." She pulled back her disheveled hair flirtatiously without a hint of anger on her face at all. Her cheerful expression obviously showed that she was not angry. "Right, I never finished my question just now. Why are you avoiding meeting up with her? I believe that you should explain the relationship between the two of you while possible and ally with illusory demon sect sooner." Song Tina brought up business once more. I promised Zuli that I would do my best to help her inside the graveyard of the gods if I see her. However, it would seem that I couldn't help her out much at all, and telling her about my relationship with Zuli would make it look like I'm requesting something from her through this connection or something. After all, she is stronger than us right now, and she herself is a pretty strong-willed person. Kinlai touched his own chin. Song Tina began making a fuss. Since when are you so good at understanding others? Oh, wait a second. You're good at undressing others as well. She glanced at her own clothes and said not too subtly. Kinlai let out a dry laugh. Didn't you care for her at every turn when we first met her? Don't tell me it is all because of Zuli. Song Tini could not quite believe it. Zhu Moyan may appear to be extremely strong right now, but, sigh, her lifespan is limited. If she does not have a fortuitous encounter in this examination and acquire a precious holy medicine, she... Kinlai shook his head. This girl is actually pretty pitiful. Adding that to my friendship with Zuli, I believe that it is best that I aid her from the shadows as much as I can. I do not want to give her too much trouble. As you know, I am a restless person, and my luck has always been kind of rotten. Trouble comes to me very easily. If I told her about our relationship too early, I may cause her to fall into my trouble so soon that she does not have the time to sort out her own things. You do not want to disturb her own pace. Song Tina came to a realization. Kinlai nodded slightly. BZZBZZZZZ. An odd noise abruptly rang from inside his spatial ring. Before he could figure out the cause, the eight-winged centipede queen's wings abruptly flew out of his spatial ring. Kinlai and Song Tina's expressions changed at the same time. Swoosh swoosh swoosh. The eight wings abruptly flapped towards the distance and vanished in a flash. They looked like arrows that had pierced through the air. It must be Yi Yao's doing. Kinlai snorted. What powerful summoning strength. You've already put all eight wings inside the spatial ring, but the mother insect was still able to detect them, Song Tina said while feeling shocked on the inside. Yi Yao may be coming up with some new scheme very soon. Kinlai smelled something fishy from this. Should I notify Chu Li and the others? MN. At the same time, the token around his waist let out a melodious ring. The token belonged to 10,000 Beast Mountain. The ringing meant that the 10,000 Beast Mountain martial practitioners had also discovered his location. Kinlai grabbed the token and probed around for a bit. His expression grew heavier and heavier. Those guys from 10,000 Beast Mountain had come over. If they dare come to us at this kind of time, they must have found some powerful reinforcements. Song Tinu thought for a moment before saying with certainty, they must have met with the core ringer of 10,000 Beast Mountain, you men.